Hello, everybody. Happy Wednesday. Gotta adjust my microphone here. Can you hear me okay? All right. All right. So, by request, we're going to be doing a Rocket Raccoon and Groot piece today. I already did the flats, but I got to do some adjusting and stuff, so... Hey, April! So, I'm just going to do some adjusting here. Maybe come in and do some little details on the gun. Hello, happy Wednesday. It would help if I selected the right tool. Just want to go in and just add a few little variants in color on this thing. Oh, I just noticed he's got a little hand back there. Oh, damn. Well, I hope everyone's had a good week. I am glad it is at the midway point, I'll tell you that much. Glad to sit down and zone out for the next couple hours with you guys. I think that's just enough, a little bit of detail on that gun there. I think with Groot, he's all bark and everything. I think I want to go in and actually just add a slight variation to his arm that's in the foreground here. See if we can't get it to separate a little. Help if I did that on the right layer. Ooh. Think that helps. Just a real minor variation, just a get it to stand out a little bit, or make it seem like it's there, not getting lost. And jump in the background. I think I'm gonna mess around with some gradients, do something like purple to black kind of gradient or something. Might be kind of fun. Make it look like a galaxy, like one of my paintings. Can't quite get my zoom right. It just wants to zoom all the way out. There you go. Oh. I think that'll be interesting. Think we're just gonna start with the background first today. I don't know, feeling a little spicy. I think I have something that's kind of star-like or twinkly. Sparkles. Here we go. Let's mess around. See what we got. Take the opacity of those down just a little bit. I don't want them to jump off the page and become any sort of focal point. Grab a pink. Dial that down. Yeah, that's fun. Merge those layers all to the background. Now they're all in one background layer. Then we get to mess with some planets. That'll be fun. We'll make that color. Why not? We'll go in and grab airbrush. Thanks, April. Add a little dimension to it. On that side. Then on a new layer, we'll try and figure out some sort of cool texture to throw on that. What up, Daryl? Hell yeah, Rocket and Groot. April's been asking for a Rocket Raccoon for a long time. Figure it's about time. April knows what's up. Fair enough. Just have some subtle texture back there going on that planet. Merge those layers. Throw another layer on top for some more shadow and highlight, because I realized that put that all in one layer. Man, killing myself. Let's try that again. There we go. There we go. That looks like a planet. All right, I need some color combinations. Let's do these planets together. I kind of want to find an image of the Death Star and just kind of like superimpose it on that orange planet in the back. Blue and green. Okay, let's do blue and green. That's more what I was looking for. There we go. We got a little blue and green planet back there. I feel we might need to bump the saturation up on that just a little bit. There we go. May need to come back down. We'll see what it looks like when I'm done. All right. What are some other cool color combinations for this last planet there? Orange and purple. We got a bunch of purple going on in the background already. Okay, we'll do yellow and orange. Well, you know what? Maybe we'll add a little glow to that one. Just 'cause. It's a fair point. I asked the group for color, and she didn't come up with pink. She did drop purple though. If Bob Ross did plants, by the way, I feel like that's exactly what he'd say. Plant. Oh, planets. Gotcha. What? I don't know what I said. What did I say? Was. Right, that glow is a little strong. I'm actually gonna blur that glow. Way to branch out. There we go. There's some pretty cool planets. That's a cool looking background. Add a little glow. All right, and on this planet here, we're just gonna add a happy little glow. I feel like I got a lot to live up to on the foreground since I did that background and the way I did. Oh, I'm spilling my damn coffee everywhere. Wow, that only took a half hour. We'll have to take our time a little bit with these guys. think we'll start with Groot. We'll grab his silhouette. We'll drop in a shadow layer. Now, I always use this kind of neutral color for shadows, which ends up being a brown. So, I wonder if we'll even be able to see shadows here. Oh, yeah, that's no problem. Oh, yeah, definitely no problem. Okay. Yeah, fair enough. I do know how to paint some planets. Now Groot's gonna be interesting. He has a lot of interesting shapes about him. So tackling this is going to be interesting. He has a general shape. Then it also comes around. It's very cylindrical head, but I also feel like the bark bits are kind of their own individual shapes on top of the cylinder. It's weird. It's a weird one. So what I think I'll do, I'll treat this in a different kind of way. I think I'll do a very light pass of just generally where the light's coming from. Real light, so I have enough to continue to remove more. And I'll remove more with some sort of texture. There is a fun texture that I like to do with plants. I just gotta find it. Ooh, what's this? I don't know that I've ever used this. Is that even doing anything? No, it's not even doing anything. Okey-doke. So many dang brushes. Let's try this one. That's why I wasn't doing anything. I had his arm selected, and I'm trying to color outside of it, and I wonder why it's not working. Oh. Ooh, that's a fun texture. I think we'll stick with this. I like that. I like that texture. Is he shooting the planet? That tells me that I need to push that planet in the background a bit more. Yeah, it does a little bit. It does a little bit. I'll give it to you. Now, Groot typically has like some mossy bits. Some mossy colors. In a few spots. So I think I'll hit him with some greens in a few places. Yeah, I think that's working for me. It feels like Groot. Oh, wrong layer. There we go. Yeah, thanks. I like it a lot too. I think it's working. It's working. think he definitely feels like Groot. Feels like he's wood plant guy. Wood plant guy, man. It's vibing, right? Thanks, dog. Rocket'll be fun with all the different fur and all that good stuff. Let's go ahead and jump right on in and get him squared away. Let's see. Come with my soft round brush and just do the generals again where that light will likely be hitting. Keep it real light though, that way I can come in with some textures. I think I'll pretty much work that gun separately. His snoot. All right. I want to go that route. Maybe I'll go that route on the base, and then maybe I'll come back in and do some other passes. So it might look weird for a little while here. Yes, trust the process. I don't dislike where that's headed as a base for the fur. Think when I drop in the highlights, I might come through and just do another pass texture. I think that'll be the way to go. Go ahead and do his gear. I think that gives it just a little touch of dimension there. Did it again. Ari knows what's up. Yeah, I like how that's coming along. I think we're gonna go in and add just a little bit of texture to his armor or his clothes or whatever you want to call that stuff. But what was that? Oh, that's Groot stuff. Okay, drop that down. Add a texture layer here. Just a little bit of texture. Not a whole lot. Just throw a little red in there. That is it for the shadows. We'll move on to some more highlights and effects, and I gotta finish that gun as well. So yeah, I'm gonna take a quick 5 minutes. I'll be back and we'll press on. So be right back. All right, everybody, I'm back. For those of you that stuck around, thanks for hanging. All right. Let's figure out what I was gonna do. Oh, I gotta do that gun. Thank you. I lost my shadow color. That's another reason why I always just start with the same shadow color. Because if I'm cruising along and I lose the color, I mean, I can go through the color history, that's a thing, but I always forget about it. Yeah, we'll probably call that good enough. Yeah, we'll call that good enough. Let's go ahead and let's switch it over to some highlights. What's great about this is they're in space and there's no obvious light source. So I mean, there is, but we don't know what color it is. It could be anything. So why don't you guys throw out some colors for a light source and we'll see what sticks and what looks neat. My coffee's gone. Some pinks. Let's see if that'll reduce the lag. Sorry about that. Appear to be lagging quite a bit. All right. Let's throw around some pinks. You know, if I'm gonna do pink, it's gonna have to be pretty soft. You know, I almost, with the color palette, I almost don't even need color. That's okay. We'll go ahead and we'll put it right here for the time being. That's not too bad. So let's go ahead and mess around with those shadows. Let's try and make the shadows a green. I like the green shadows on the brown. I think it looks cool. I'll have to take the shadows down a peg on the gun, but that's okay.
Let's bounce around a little. Yeah, I agree. The pink and green really made Groot the focus in a good way. But I don't know that the green works so well with Rocket since he's wearing orange. So when you add green and orange, you almost get this really muddy gray color. I wasn't feeling that. I wonder if we can swing it down here a bit. Let's try this. I almost kind of want to do purple. Just because the galaxy background is purple, so maybe that's kind of bouncing in. Then I think it just takes everything a little too. Well, I guess that's not bad. Let's copy that. That didn't work. What was that all about? There we go. Take the highlights on Rocket down a little bit. You might get some on the fur, but really, it should kind of diffuse that light a little bit. Yeah, we can try that. Yeah, why not? Let's try like a red orange and see what that looks like. Why not? Hard light again. That's too much. Something's happening here that I'm just not liking. Color dye. Yeah, I think we'll just stick with that maybe. I do need to address the background just because it is a bit much. Try and tone that down a little bit. Then I really want to pump up the saturation. Here. Just overall. I think that's working for me. I think I'm feeling that. Think I want to try and work some more grays into his fur and see what I think about that. In a few places. I feel like I'm missing that bit of color variance. Yeah, he is a bit dark, I agree. I wonder if maybe I bring Groot down a bit. In an attempt to bring Rocket forward just a little bit more. Let's do a grayscale comparison here, just to see what we have going on. So yeah, they're pretty dark, and I think some of that has to do with the background almost being the same tone as the foreground in this area here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to shift around this background a bit. We'll check that out and see if we get a better separation. It's still pretty tonal. Dang. So if I desaturate it, I'm going to lose quite a bit, but if I oversaturate, I'm worried it's going to get a little too wild. But we'll see. Nope. What should we do? What should we do? I mean, we can force it by just making it black. Definitely get a quite a bit different there. But if I do that, then Rocket and Groot feel way saturated in contrast. I agree. I like the purple better. I'm just not getting contrast that I need. And that's not making me happy. Maybe if I drop that luminosity down a bit. Let's try that. Oh, there we go. I think yeah, I'm getting enough separation there. And you can still see the purple in the background and stuff. I think that'll work. But I think when I desaturated Groot, I did it a disservice. Now the eye is immediately drawn to the planets. And the reason why it's drawn directly to the planets is because we have insane contrast happening. Because we have all this dark followed by the brightest spot on the page in these spots. When I go into grayscale, you can really see how that's just directing the eye, just boom, right there. Rather than putting it off the characters where it needs to be. So what do we do? Let's try dulling them down, see what happens. Whoa. What the heck? Why are you doing that? I can't really brighten Rocket anymore without losing his details. So I have to offset that contrast. I have to darken everything else so he seems brighter. I think no matter what I do, it's just... I don't like it. Get out of there. Oh, that was trippy. I'll show you. I will go back to Rocket here. Deselect all that. Go back to Rocket. What are you doing? Must have hit a weird keyboard combination. See, the more I try and brighten them, the more we kind of lose everything. No, he looks kind of one color, even though he's definitely not. Let's try and go back here. Oh, that looks kind of neat. I don't mind that. It's a little wild, but they're in space, so that's okay. Maybe. I am feeling very indecisive tonight. I apologize. I don't know what the hell my deal is. Yeah, we're not going to stick with that. We're going right back to the purple. Right back to the purple. I'm over it. Yeah, I'm going in now and trying to hit up some more variations. It's not working well. Going in and trying to brighten where I can. That came out way too bright. Whoa. Okay. You know, I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at that. Yeah, I think that came out pretty good for Rocket, for me being so indecisive. I was able to brighten him up quite a bit, which is great. I was getting really annoyed. But now I feel like Groot needs just like the littlest bit of love. Maybe. I think just in some of these spots, just to add just a touch more dimension. Not a lot. Don't want to go crazy. Oh no, went the wrong way again. Just adding a little bit of subtle shifts in highlights to Groot. So this is barely, it's not wholly noticeable, but your eyes do notice. Ooh, sorry if that's loud. Banging my mic around. My bad, y'all. My bad. Yeah, I like Groot. I was able to get a whole, or not Groot. I mean, I like Groot, but I like the fur of Rocket. I was able to get a lot of different color variation in there, I feel. Color wheel and the layers and stuff. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, it was a much needed change. Kind of helps to see what's going on. You can kind of see why I might get confused from time to time by selecting the wrong layers. Yeah, thanks, Daryl. And grab that white and just, whoa, not do that. Just try and draw that eye in a little more with those really bright, bright whites. Any little thing helps. By the way, Arya says you should do all baby animals for her birthday. Baby Groot, baby Yoda, baby unicorn. Shove them all in the same universe. We'll see what we can do. Paint away those lines a little bit. Why not? All right. You like the way she th Yeah, I'm sure you do. Where is my navigator window? There we go. All right, we'll come in and we will go ahead and drop the old signature on this one. Throw that down there. There we go. And I think we'll call that finished. I don't think that looks bad at all. Sometimes, yeah, you were right. You gotta trust the process. Just keep moving through, because every piece of art has an ugly phase. And yeah, I kind of got stuck in that ugly phase for a little bit. But overall, I think I like the end result on this. So what do you guys think? Do you like it? Do you love it? Do you hate it? You think I should quit being an artist? What do you guys think? I am still getting a hell of a lot of latency. Awesome. Awesome. Well, if anybody has any suggestions for next week's piece, shoot me a message, let me know, and I'll see what I can do. But otherwise, I think we're just going to call it here. We're about 10 minutes early, but that's all right. I really thought I was going to knock this out in like 45 minutes, and that was not the case. April, I think you found a great balance between the light and dark, but still kept everything I liked about it about the beginning. Yeah, I took a weird roundabout path to finding that balance. You can see Rocket, even his eyes, though, so well done. Yeah, well, yeah, thank you. All right, gang, I'm gonna go ahead and call it a night, and we will catch you next Wednesday. Have a good night.